Hello!
Hello!
I'm here with my favorite white woman, Sophia Clark. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna sit here and we're just gonna do our makeup and talk about
Broadway.
So, tell me a little about yourself.
My resume or myself?
Both.
Well, I go to Sam Houston with Cam. I transferred in from Lone Star originally.
Is that primary?
This is the Hangover RX primer. So when you've had a beverage or two. Good. I'm a junior now. I transferred in from Lone Star, so it's good. I've grown a lot in the program. I'm ready to graduate. I'm ready to get out. So that's me.
Why did you want to do theater? Like, what about it? When did you start?
Okay. Well, I have always done, I've always been, like, when I was a kid, I was really active. And I used to do figure skating and stuff, and I loved that. And I played soccer for a little while. I did, like, little dancey, like, you know, little kid dance. But what I liked about each one of those, like, especially, like, figure skating was, like, performing, you know, and then when I was in like third grade, my teacher, Miss Hogan, we did a class play. And it was we used to have these things called reading buddies. And they were like little kindergartners that you help teach them to read and stuff. And so we did a little play for our reading buddies. And I like really liked it. And she was like, Sophia, you're really good at this. Like,
how old are you?
I was like 8. Have you ever considered like doing theater or, you know, and I was like, no, girl, what, you know?
You're going to be a vet. Like, a veterinarian.
So, and she was like, well, you should like think about it. Like, you're good at that. I was like, okay, girl. But then so I was still doing figure skating, and then I started doing figure skating. And I did this thing called Drama Kids, which is like, just like after school, like with like a community organization for theater and stuff. Yeah. And I really liked it. And then my mom was like, okay, you have to choose figure skating or theater, because you can't do both, because it's just too so time consuming. Yeah. And I was like, okay, theater. And so I started doing theater then when I was like 8 or 9, and it started with Drama Kids. Like, we did shows, like just small made up ones. And then I started doing stuff at Applause Theater. And then I did some stuff at HVAC, which is now called Stage Works. I did a lot of camps there. And then I just did stuff through my middle school and high school. And I'm at college and like starting to work professionally. So that's nice. What about you, Cammie?
You know, it all started with a purple dinosaur, I always say. watching Barney and really just... like loving to sing, loving to dance, loving to act, and just like, oh, like this is all cool. And then when I was in elementary school, we did Peddler Polly and the Story Stealer. And I got cast as a narrator, and I
remember
was
my first play, too. Well, my one line was, my first line was, oh, fiddlesticks, old Bartholomew's the wisest man in the village. His advice must be good.
Hello, I bet you milked that.
Oh, you know I did. We all had to pick a pose, and I was like churning butter, all Aunt Eller.
Narrator 2 in Peddler Polly and the Storyteller. Not sure, because I was like, narrator 2? I was like, sis.
There's one.
All right, let me be the lead. We did like our Christmas show, and everybody was like, let Cameron do like the big dance, let Cameron do the big dance. And I was like, what are you guys talking about? Like, me? Little old me?
Little old me.
And I did the big dance and I stole the show.
Exactly.
And, you know, I was like, I can get used to this. I got used to it.
Being the star.
And look at me now. And then middle school, I was really like, okay, so this is what... So musical theater. I was like, okay, this is how you sing, dance, and act at the same time. You know, and then when you're growing up and you tell everybody you want to be an actor, they're all like, oh, you want to be in movies and TV? And I'm like, not really. I wouldn't be on Broadway.
And they're like,
what's that? I'm like, oh, you're gay. you know, and I never really got to like, go to theater camp or anything when I was younger. Cause like it just didn't work out like that for mm-hmm. anybody to pay for me to do it. So I was just like, okay. So I had to just watch Disney Channel and get my skills from TV and do what I could here and there.
Well, some of the best actors have little to no training, and right. now you have training, you
right,
know,
right.
through the school.
Right. And then I was like, you know what, I want to do this. And it was never really my goal to come to college from musical theater. Mm-hmm. Like, I wanted to, like, Carnegie Mellon, because I was like, ooh, like, cool. Mm-hmm. But I, like, just wanted to be, like, a star on Disney Channel. And I was like, you know what, like, I just want to move to New York. And it was just like, girl, go to school. Because, mm-hmm. like, just get some cushion, you know. Like, I if I would have moved to New York when I wanted to, I would have been shook.
I was good, and, like, Tommy Tune Award nomination good.
You're
but,
you know, too, girl.
But not what it takes to be, like, what I am now or what it takes to be anything. Like, oh, she's pursuing musical theater, and I'm like, I'm kind of good now,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
What is, like, I have a question for you. What is, like, the point in your career where you were, like, I have what it takes. Like, I could actually do this. You know, what was, like, a one moment, or was it, you know, multiple moments that you were like, I have what it takes? You know?
When I got that call back for Genie, I think, to go to New York and all that, like, I was like, oh, I'm a star. Okay. What about you?
I think it was a combination of things. Booking Xanadu was great. I mean, it was my first professional show.
Yeah.
And it was eye-opening mm-hmm. to, like, how much more I needed to grow, you know?
Yeah.
And then I would say getting A1 mm-hmm. and being one of the only four girls who got it the first time around, and being the only girl who received callbacks from
that,
I was shook.
Auditioning for regional stuff is difficult for my type, just because not every season is gonna be for the big black man, or even for sis.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, okay, you know.
Yeah.
Well,
and I think, like, what is happening on Broadway now, and it's translating to a lot of regional theaters, is they're being a lot more inclusive.
Right.
Which is good, you know? Yeah. And I think that their seasons should start to reflect that, in the sense that they should do more shows that are written for people of color specifically.
Right.
And then also cast them, colorblind casting,
exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's not just okay just to do colorblind casting, because it's like, you need to do shows that tell a story about people of color as well, not just white people. Mm-hmm. Broadway is not very inclusive with mm-hmm. a lot of stuff. Like, they are in some cases, but, and even, like, regional theaters and stuff are maybe not the most inclusive. It's getting there, you know? It is. It's getting there. But it's hard, because it's like, I need to eat.
I don't think the trick is, like, starving yourself. I think it's knowing your branding.
Oh, no, I meant that paycheck.
Sometimes, like, I'd be like, look, fuck the message. Look, I just need the coin.
What is your, like, stance on type? And, like, what people see as their type or don't see as their type?
I think on a beginning college level, like, where we are mm-hmm. right now, what I would say to, like, freshmen and stuff is know your type.
Now that we're old, withered women.
Yeah, like first you need to know your type, because you need to know what
people
they're
see
gonna see you as, mm-hmm. so you can know what to tell them you are as well. And I don't mind it, like, I don't mind type, it's the reason why people work, but you have mm-hmm. to, like, know it, and you can't be ignorant about it. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one of the biggest, like, misconceptions, especially in school. Everybody wants to be something they're not, and then are confused as to why they don't work.
It, like, settled on, my type wasn't just pretty girl ingenue, you know what I mean? I can play a villain, I can play this, I can play that, which I am a villain in real life. You know, and but if I'm ever gonna play Ursula, you know what I mean? Like Sherry Renee Scott, who looks just like me. You know, if I'm ever gonna play Ursula, I have to have the credits to get me in that room.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
And so you can't break your box out of your box if you don't have a box to begin with.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah. What is your dream show?
Oh Lord. Dream show to sit down and watch and just, like, be in awe of the production
mm-hmm.
is Hunchback. Like, I don't necessarily, I would just love to be the ensemble of that, just singing it.
Yeah.
Legally Blonde is one of my favorite shows. Les Mis is one of my favorite shows. I'd like to play Les. I would like to do Les Mis several times. Mm. Oh, last 5 years as well. Mm-hmm. I think I make a great Jamie.
I've been thinking about this a lot because, like, I really wanted to be like Broadway, Broadway, Broadway. Like, I want to make my Broadway debut by the end of the year, but I want to make my name off of stories that are original, mm-hmm. and I want to tell stories that I am kin to, and not a story that wasn't originally made for me. I want to originate a role that is a non-binary performer that dresses the way they dress and does what they do, but still have a meaty story that tells, like, a story of love, like have a love interest, like that's something that I want, you know.
Yeah. Have and be a love interest.
Right, right, and you know somebody thinks that my character is beautiful, or mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. just stuff like that. Like I want
stuff that resembles everyday people.
Exactly, exactly, yeah. And really represent those black kids out there who like is like, okay, what about us?
I like remakes, like I like things like Mean Girls and Pretty Women that are like revamping what's already there.
Yeah, I don't hate adaptations. Like, some people like some have people this like huge aversion to adaptations.
I'm like, don't go to the audition then.
Right. you know, it's not such a big deal. It's okay.
I'm like, theater is theater.
Right. What's the most boring show you saw on Broadway?
You want to fight. The one I least enjoyed was King Kong. Mm. I am a song person and a storybook person, you know, and that was what I was missing. I think the book wasn't strong enough. Tech-wise, it's incredible. You know, I thought the leading actress was amazing mm-hmm. as well. And I thought, the use of diverse casting is wonderful, you know. It's a pity because I wish they had maybe not rushed as much. I don't know how long the process took with the book, but took another second to look at the book.
Yeah.
And I feel like it would have a more successful run. And, you know.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm like, that's when I least enjoy. The show that I was most emotionally moved by is a tie between Once on This Island and Come From Away.
Mm. Anastasia. Anastasia did not do it for me at all. I was asleep. I was knocked out.
What's the most emotionally moving? Not maybe necessarily the best show you've seen on Broadway, but like the
color
most
purple.
Color Purple.
Yeah, the Color Purple.
Did you see it with Cynthia?
Yeah, I saw it. Cynthia, oh, Heather, God. And Danielle. I'm shook.
With Danielle too.
Yeah.
Oh my God. What's a show you wish you could have seen on Broadway?
Hamilton. Original cast. Not having the album, because seeing Hamilton was great,
uh-huh.
and like I was so happy, like I had a friend in the show, and like it was amazing, but I was just like, dang, like I wish I wasn't so. This was like two years after the soundtrack, so my so in my ear, you uh-huh. know what I mean. I think if I could go back in time, I would be like, can I see Dreamgirls? Like if I could go and go to the opening night of Dreamgirls, I'd go to Dreamgirls.
Uh-huh.
What about you?
It's like Miss Saigon with Eva. I would love to have seen that. And we were in New York when
I'm shy. But I didn't see her.
But I was one of the biggest roles I ever had. Mm, you know, was and I originally was Serena, and then I was Elle's understudy.
What happened? Killed the bitch.
No, I think I got one show as Elle. Originally, the first time I did it, and then
the first time you did it.
Yeah, and then the second time I was Elle.
Mm.
I don't.
Alex was the girl who. Do you think the girl who did it was better than you? Dun, 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 dun. I don't know why it's in my head. It's a good song, though. This is too much.
You want to have the conversation?
What?
My musical theater major's like, I don't like musicals.
Oh, hate them.
I think when people say they don't like musicals when they're MT majors, it's like they don't like the fun, crazy, which we have.
Right.
You know?
But they say like they're not a fan of it. Like, they're not, I'm not a fan of musical theater.
Yeah.
And it's like, but this is your major. You're paying thousands of dollars to do this. Like,
so why don't
I don't get it, you know?
And the thing is, and it's like, you don't have to be so, like snort musical theater.
Right.
You know?
Like,
To, like, love it and appreciate it.
I don't know why some people just choose to live in an unhappy state.
I have decent lips for a white girl. They kind of small right now. Don't look.
The bottom one is kind of thick.
What is a Broadway performer you think is completely underrated? like how good they are.
All of my faves are like rated.
Which Sierra one? Renee.
Yes.
What? So incredibly talented.
Well, I didn't really think she's underrated.
I think she's, I just remember watching that on the line, I was like, oh my God, you're so good. And I think what I like about Sierra Renee Scott, when I talked about her earlier, is that she's not my favorite of each role, you know, but she, for me, is someone I look up to.
Who is someone like you can't wait to see on Broadway?
That I'm like, oh, I just want to see. Wife's Island was amazing because I got to see so many people I had wanted to see in one show.
It like cured my Norm Lewis.
I saw the closing matinee, so a lot of the originals came back. And then seeing Mean Girls with the original cast.
Yes, that was, I'm blessed to have done that. Are you done?
I'm done with you. Who don't know what a man's about? Pay the bills, keep paying the telephone bills.
Hold on. You know, I could never do a wing. I just...